Hello viewers, it's Nahida-san from Team Kalosan BD. Today we'll have a discussion on blood group and mismatched blood transfusion. Let's imagine a situation. You are a renowned doctor. A patient needs A negative blood, but you have B positive, O positive, and O negative blood in stock. You don't have enough time to find a donor for A negative blood. Now what you need to do? To solve the problem, we will first learn some basic concepts of blood group by answering some simple questions. Our first question is, what is blood group? Blood group refers to groups of blood which is classified according to the antigen present in the cell membrane of RBC. These antigens marks red blood cell with different identities. They are also called agglutinogens, as they may cause agglutination through antigen-antibody reaction. Here this antibody is gamma globulin. They are also called agglutinin. They are present in plasma and may be IgM and IgG. There are 30 commonly occurring antigens and hundreds of other rare antigens. But two of them cause blood transfusion reaction much more than others. They are ABO system of antigens and Rh system. So we found two commonly occurring blood group system. They are ABO and Rh. In ABO system, there are two types of antigen, antigen A and antigen B. If a person have antigen A in the RBC membrane, his or her blood group will be A. In the case of presence of antigen B, the blood group will be B. In the case of presence of both of them, the blood group will be AB. And if none of them is present, it will be O. On the other hand, six types of antigen are responsible for Rh system. They are expressed by capital C, D, E, and small c, D, E. Of these six antigens, mainly antigen D represents Rh system. Presence of it refers to Rh positive, and absence of it refers to Rh negative. Our next question is, what is the origin of these antigens? Answer is, they are gene determined. So we achieve them from our parents. Well, here we were talking about antigens. Now we will go for antibodies. These antibodies are also termed as agglutinins. In ABO system, there are two antibodies. They are anti-A antibody and anti-B antibody. At the time of birth, they are absent. But after birth, they develop. Antigen A and B enter the body in food, bacteria, and in other ways, and development of their antibodies initiate. On the other hand, in Rh system, there is anti-D antibody. In both Rh positive and negative blood, this antibody is absent. But if any individual with Rh negative blood gets antigen D somehow, like blood transfusion, his body will develop anti-D antibody. Now an important question. What is blood typing? It's a process by which blood type of any person is determined. Now, we will see the process by which it is done. First, blood is collected from a person. Then, his red blood cells are being mixed with antisera containing agglutinins, which means antibody. Then we are to wait for agglutination. If agglutination takes place, red blood cells become clumped. For an example, if the agglutination occurs by mixing the blood with anti-A agglutinin, the blood group will be A. Another important question is, what is the importance of determining one's blood group? The importance are to avoid mismatched blood group, for paternity test by MN blood group, and to identify blood disease. Now, we need to know about a law. It is Lam Steiners Law. It is important both for viva and written exam. This law has two parts. The first part states that if an agglutinogen, which means antigen, is present on the RBC, the corresponding agglutinin, that means antibody, must be absent. Like, if antigen A is present in RBC, anti-A antibody will be absent. And second part states that if an agglutinogen is absent in RBC, the corresponding agglutinin must be present. That means in A blood group, antigen B is absent. So, anti-B antibody is present in A blood group. Another important question is, why ABO blood group is called classical blood group? It is called so because it is the principal blood group system which absolutely obeys Lam Steiners law. Now look at the case which we faced early in the video. A patient needs A negative blood. You have B positive, O positive and O negative blood in the stock. Now you need to choose a blood group from aforesaid three types of blood, as you have not enough time to find a donor. From the Lam Steiners law, we learned the person with blood group A have antigen A and anti-B antibody. So, if we transfuse B positive blood within the patient, the RBCs of transfused blood will be clumped by antigen antibody reaction. In the case of O positive blood, there is no ABO antigen, but it has antigen D. So, if the patient is already sensitized to Rh antigen, there will be clump. But if the patient has not developed anti-D antibody yet, O positive blood can be transfused. It will trigger to develop anti-D antibody within the body of the patient. So, the best option is O negative because it has no antigen and it will not trigger to develop anti-D antibody. That is why O negative blood group is called universal donor. On the other hand, AB positive blood group has A, B and D antigen. So, it lacks anti-A, anti-B and anti-D antibody. If any of A, B, AB and O blood is transfused within the person, there will be no reaction because AB positive group has no antibody. For this reason, AB positive group is called universal recipient. But you may have a question. O negative blood group has both anti-A antibody and anti-B antibody. If we supply the patient with O negative blood. Won't be there any problem? The answer will be no, because the amount of antibody is very little. When the blood is transfused in the body, the antigen becomes diluted. You may ask a question. O negative blood has both anti-A antibody and anti-B antibody. If you supply the patient with O negative blood, won't be there any problem? The answer will be no, because the amount of antibody is very little. When the blood is transfused in the body, the antibody becomes diluted, so it has almost no effect. So what we found? We found that you can give the patient O negative blood. Now we'll go for our another topic, mismatched blood transfusion. What is it? It refers to transfusion of blood to an individual with a blood group which is not his own. In the case of mismatched blood transfusion, antigen-antibody reaction occurs. This reaction has some immediate effect and some delayed effect. Immediate effects may be shivering and restlessness, nausea and vomiting, tightness in the chest, decreased blood pressure and shock. Delayed effects may be hemolysis, hemolytic jaundice, hemolytic anemia and acute kidney failure. This acute kidney failure happens due to renal vasoconstriction, circulatory shock and renal blockage. Renal vasoconstriction takes place because of toxic substance released from antigen-antibody reaction. Circulatory shock is caused by huge loss of circulating RBCs. And thirdly, excess amount of released hemoglobin cause block the renal tubules. This is all about blood group and mismatched transfusion. If you like this video, please share and subscribe our channel to support us. Thank you.